All right, we're going to put together a PC gaming monster for as little as possible without making any irresponsible decisions, because we don't want to regret our decisions. We want to enjoy them. I want to say thanks to our sponsor, Fractal Design. You're looking at my new case, the Define R5. They've kept the clean Scandinavian design, and they've kept the silence, but they've also added a ModuVent system that allows you to choose between more cooling or more silence. Speaking of cooling, you can fit up to a 420 radiator in the top, a 360 radiator in the front, 240 in the bottom, and also a 140 in the rear. So lots of cooling options. For more information, be sure to click on the link on the screen and be sure to check out our full video overview. Let's get down to business, shall we? We're going to go AMD with this one because right now the deals for this season are ridiculous on this old technology. It's old, but per dollar, it's super fast. So let's start off with a motherboard, the MSI 970A G34, not ridiculously laden with features, but really good for the money. It does support Crossfire and SLI, so there you have that. On the back, you can see we have a couple of USB 3, but nothing too special. For everything, not so good for overclocking, but that's what you get for $50. You probably won't be overclocking too much unless you invest in a fancy cooling unit. So there's that to think about as well. I'd probably just get this, save the money, and all the money you saved, you know, by not getting a water cooling unit, spend it on a better graphics card. It makes everything faster. So, all right, let's move right along and check out the CPU. Guys, it's just too good of a deal right now. The 8350 for $139. Just buy it. It's an 8-core. I mean, it's not as fast per core compared to Intel stuff. If you're streaming, I would probably rather have one of these than a lot of the Intel i5s. So yeah, price to performance ratio, nothing even comes close to this 8350. Go ahead and grab it if you want a nice fancy gaming rig. If you're gonna do productivity, well, we should probably talk about Intel, but we'll do that in a different video. All right, moving right along here, let's get some memory in this. Now the Kingston HyperX Fury, you know, DDR3 has gone like up and down and up and down in price. $69 is not bad for the 8GB kit. It's just decent, reliable, fast memory. I've got a few of these HyperX Fury kits and I quite enjoy them. So as far as the graphics cards go, I'm gonna give you guys a few different options. If you wanna go all out, you can do that. But if you wanna save some money, I'll give you an option for that as well. So first off, let's go all out and get the GTX 970. This card is extremely efficient and just really, really fast for the money. My favorite GPU of the year. Unless the 390X comes out, we'll see how fast that is. But, you know, for the money, this thing has been really a sweet spot out of everything. It's got insane performance, you know, like 1440p gaming all day long maxed out with this card. And for $349 for something with a, you know, an aftermarket cooling unit, especially the WinForce here from Gigabyte, not gonna be sad about that at all. Another thing I want to note is this card, the fans don't even really kick on until you get somewhere between 60 and 70 degrees Celsius. So it's extremely silent. All right, that's the top option. You wanna save a little bit of money, but get still a lot of performance. The Asus R9 290X, this is the DirectCU 2 edition with the fancy cooling unit there and those massive heat pipes there. These things have come down in price so much. And you know, AMD also takes advantage of Mantle, and in games like Thief, you get a huge FPS boost. Not a lot of games take advantage of Mantle yet, but when the games do take advantage of Mantle, this card beats the 970. Otherwise, the 970 and this are pretty neck and neck in most games, with the 970 getting a slight edge. However, for the price, if you want to do this, you know, stupid rebate here on the screen, I don't know if you want to do that or not, but for the price, it's a damn good way to go. All right, let's step down one more time for you guys and check out the 280X. It's on sale for $214. It's a Sapphire branded card, and if you guys know anything about my preferences, I love Sapphire branded cards for AMD because they make the reference stuff for AMD, so they get to play around with it before any of the other companies do. They really know the architecture and they do a decent job with all of their other stuff. So I do like Sapphire quite a bit. And this price for a 280X is really good. 280Xs are one of the best cards out there for just 1080p maxed out gaming all day long. So this with the 8-core and you've got a ridiculous price performance machine. All right, moving right along here. You're gonna need some storage. And normally in an uber budget build, I wouldn't recommend an SSD, but the Kingston SSD now is on sale and it's only $50 for 120 gigabytes or 91 for 240 gigabytes. Just go ahead and get the 240 gigabyte version and that should be enough for all your games and everything else like that. If you need to store extra stuff that you normally would acquire just by going to the internet, you should probably get a hard drive out of an old computer. Maybe just cannibalize one from like your sister's computer or your dad's computer. Just take one out of there. No one will notice that there's a hard drive missing unless there's only one in there. I do not condone this activity, and if you get in trouble, I do not have anything to do with it, and I will not take responsibility. All right, moving right along here. You're going to need a power supply for this. A couple different options here with the power supply. I mean, well, this is the one I would pick, but there's also a thermal tank I saw in here for, you know, slightly less money. Anyway, 600 watt is going to be plenty enough for this. You may be able to get by with 500 watt, but depending on the GPU configuration you go with, if you go with the GTX 970, you might be able to get by with the 500 watt, but I would definitely recommend going with the higher wattage. I mean, the price is, it's lower, but what you get with a higher wattage is a little bit more overhead, but also you don't want the power supply to be running at 100% all the time. The best efficiency is somewhere between 50 and 80%. That's where the sweet spot is for the power supply. So get a little bit more than you need always. If you think you need 600, spend a little extra money and get 750. It will make everything last a lot longer. And you also have to think of this, the power supply is, I kind of think of it as the heart, even though the CPU is really the heart. But if the CPU dies, it's the only thing that dies. If the power supply dies, well, it can take, it's the nervous system. There we go, it's the nervous system. It can take a lot of stuff with it. It can nuke the RAM. It can overheat the CPU. It can jolt, it can shock some of the PCI Express ports. It can do all kinds of terrible things. So make sure you get a decent PSU. All right, for the case, look at this cheap case from Deepcool. This is actually a decent case. I was, when I saw this price, I was like, you know what? I gotta order this case and just see how it is. And you know what? It ain't bad. It ain't bad at all. It doesn't feel all that bad. I mean, it doesn't feel like a $150 case, but it doesn't feel like a $30 case either. It feels a lot better than that. It's, of course, it's a $30 case, but it's gonna be a home for your computer. It's not the most silent case on the planet, but it's $30. You guys can obviously spend a little bit more money, and if silence is something that you really want, you know, you can go out and get a much more silent case. We just reviewed the Define R5 for like $100. It's more expensive, but it is completely silent. So just a really good way to go for the money. All right, if you guys want custom cooling, this is a good starting point, the Hyper 212 Evo. It's like the most recommended CPU cooler on the planet. Everybody uses it because it works, does a good job, and it's $35. You can also get it different places. You know, like Tiger Direct right now has it for $29, and Amazon has it for the same price there. So that's pretty much it. That will give you a really ridiculously fast system for the money. I like the fact that we were able to sneak in an SSD in this build. I think that really helps the snappiness, especially when you're talking about just doing regular things in the OS. So if you need some peripherals as well, just go over to Monoprice. Whoops, there we go. Go to Monoprice. These are so good. If you guys just saw my Black Friday video, you guys should go watch that. But I'll bring it up again here because Zoe makes some of the best competitive gaming mice on the planet with flawless sensors. These are infrared sensors, and they use the Avago ADNS 3090, I believe, and it's a flawless sensor. As far as keyboards go, you can use any keyboard. I don't really think you're going to get that much of a competitive advantage with, you know, rubber domes versus mechanical. You may have a better feel with mechanical, and some people prefer that, and I prefer that myself. But just start off with like a $10 keyboard from the freaking Goodwill or whatever. I don't care where you get it, some side of the hole in the wall. Just freaking clean that thing with some alcohol swabs and then get one of those mice and you'll be good to go. So I think that should get you good and started on a very fast gaming PC. We're gonna make a few more of these videos. We're gonna make like an Uber gaming PC. We're gonna make like a one that's like a step up from this one, you know? And then we'll make one that's a step down from this one. And then we're gonna go crazy before the end of the year and make just one that's like, you know, what you would do if you just, you know, a few SLI, a few cards in SLI and all that kind of stuff. Just what you would do if you just really didn't care and just wanted the best thing. So we'll make all those. We also have a couple of big productivity builds coming up. So stay tuned for all that. There's a lot of work to do. I just realized, man, there's a lot of work to do. So keep on watching. I wanna say thanks to all of our tech support members. That's, you know, where you go to the website. You can choose to buy us either a coffee or a beer. Thanks very much to the newest tech support member. You just got me this Hardcore Chimera. That's to you. But you guys can just click over on the screen. I believe it's on this side. And it says tech support. Then we got the music. And yeah, also other videos in the store and all that sort of thing. So yeah, all kinds of things. We'll see you guys in the next videos. Talk about this on the forum. And if you have other parts that go on sale that you know think everybody else could benefit from, post those in there as well. And we'll get a nice little talk started here for the end of the year. See you guys later. Price range. I can't think of anything in this price range that comes even worse than... Oh, my God.